Hello friends and welcome to Comsky Guide. Now I will explain a simple sorting algorithm, that is bubble sort. Bubble sort is a simple sorting algorithm which goes through a set of data. The data can be either numbers or characters and compares each member with its right neighbor. It is also called as syncing algorithm. So coming to the pseudocode, it is the pseudocode given in the standard textbook, that is Corman. Now let's look into the working of the bubble sort algorithm. Here I have taken an array A named A that consists of 7 elements which are all numbers, and initially the array is unsorted. If the array contains n elements, then the bubble sort will take n minus 1 iterations. Here total number of elements are 7, so it takes 6 iterations. For each iteration we will get the largest element in that array towards the right end. In this array 9 is the largest element, so after first iteration we will get the largest element towards the right end of the array, that is the last index of the array. So for second iteration we need not consider this largest element since it is already sorted. So now we will take n minus 1 elements, that is 6 numbers, for the second iteration. After second iteration we will get the second largest element towards the right end of the array. Here it is 8. So likewise we will get the largest element at that present array after every iteration. So finally after 6th iteration only one element is left in the array, that is unsorted. So for the 7th iteration there will be only one element, so no need for one more iteration. If you look into the number of comparisons, here it is 6 plus 5 plus and so on 1, that is for the first, in the first iteration total number of comparisons are 6, that is if it contain n elements then the total number of comparisons in the first iteration is n minus 1, in the second n minus 2, here it is 5, and for third it is n minus 3, and likewise it will continue until it is 1. So for general n elements number of comparisons are n minus 1 into n minus 2 divided by 2, and the code for this working I will be explaining in my next tutorial. Coming to the performance of this bubble sort, it has worst case and average complexity both big O of n square, where n is the number of items being sorted. And there also exist many sorting algorithms which have better complexity even for the worst case, that is big O of n log n. So bubble sort is not a practical sorting algorithm when n is very large, but when n is very small then it has the best case of big O of n. Coming to the analysis of this bubble sort, large elements at the beginning of the list are quickly swapped, that is in the first iteration only we can get the largest element, and small elements towards the right end move towards the beginning extremely slowly, that is we can't say whether the smallest element we can get after the first iteration. We can't say whether after 2 or 3 iterations we can get smallest elements towards the left end. Only after the nth iteration we can get the all smallest elements towards the left end of the array. That's why these are called as rabbits and turtles. One advantage over quick sort is that it has the ability to detect that the list is sorted in an efficient way. Suppose if we give an sorted array to the bubble sort, this pseudocode will detect the array is sorted in first iteration only, that is it has the best case of big O of n. If swap function is not used, that is if loop is not used, then k is equal to initial value, that is k is equal to 0. Only when it enters the if loop then only the value of k is changed, otherwise it remains as 0. So if the sorted array is given to the bubble sort, then it doesn't execute the if function, so the k value remains as 0 only. So After the first iteration, you will get n is equal to 0. So the while loop execution stops. Thus we can detect whether the array is sorted or not. In best case, that is big O of n. If we give the sorted array to the quick sort, then it will take big O of n log n, even for the best case also. So this is one advantage over quick sort for bubble sorting. Suppose if you have given array of elements which is already sorted and one element is added to this. Now to get the best case of this sorting algorithm, where we have to add this element, that is at the beginning or ending of the array, and what is the complexity if we add at the beginning and if we add at the ending. So now let's take a look into this. Let the array be A, and which consists of 7 elements. After the array is sorted, it will look like this, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 9. So now a new element, that is 5, is added at the beginning of the array, and consider just one case. Now again consider another case, the element is added at the end of the array, that is last of the index. Now again if we perform the sorting for these two cases, then we can say that adding an element at the front of the index, the cost of running time is less as compared to the cost of running time for the case of adding the element at the last. That is, if we add the element at the beginning, it takes less time to sort the total array. If we add at the last of the index, then it will take more time compared to the previous case. And this analysis I have explained in my blog, and go through the link that I have provided in the description of this video. In practice, bubble sort is one of the simplest sorting algorithm to implement and easy to understand. Due to its simplicity, bubble sort is often used to introduce the concept of algorithm or a sorting algorithm to introductory students. The implementation of pseudocode and the working of code I will be explaining in my next tutorial. So subscribe to this channel. Thank you.